Hey everyone, in this tutorial we're going to take a look at how you can import custom motions to iClone. You'll learn about how you can export custom animations along with the T-pose, as well as create custom human IK profiles for use in iClone. In this example, we're going to be using Blender, but the process is very similar for other 3D tools as well. Here's our motion in Blender, with only mesh showing on the left and only the skeleton on the right. To export to iClone, let's ensure we have both mesh and skeleton selected, then export to FBX from the File menu. Make sure to check Selected Objects in this case, as there are other elements in this particular scene that we don't want to export. Next, let's export the T-pose as a reference target for our animation in order to make it more accurate. I can delete the extra mesh and skeleton on each side now, select the original skeleton in the middle, and then go into pose mode. Use the A hotkey to select all of the bones, and then hit Alt-R to clear all of the transformed data and revert your character to a T-pose. In some cases, your character may have an A-pose as its default, so in that case you'll need to manually adjust it to conform to a T-pose in pose mode. Let's return to object mode, delete all the keyframes on the timeline, and make sure the character does not contain any animation data. I'll then proceed to select the character mesh and skeleton and export as an FBX using the same process. Next, let's proceed to create a human IK profile in Character Creator. I'll start by dragging in our T-pose FBX and choosing the character and humanoid options. The next step is to map all of the bones, which may take a few minutes. If you're not familiar with the mapping workflow, please check out the dedicated tutorial on our Realism Courses page. Upon mapping completion, hit the Active button, and then select Save Human IK Profile in order to save it. Now we have our T-pose from Blender, the animation, as well as a dedicated Human IK profile for use with Character Creator. The character model is now completely compatible with all Realism motions and motion tools, and you can apply a test motion to see it in action. Okay, finally let's look at importing our animation. Here in iClone, I have one of our dummy humanoid characters. For now, if I drag the animation FBX to our character in iClone, a notice will pop up saying that there is currently no matching human IK profile assigned. As you can probably guess, the next step then is to load up our previously saved human IK profile in the next window that pops up. You can also load in the original T-pose FBX as well. You'll want to set the frames per second to 60, and we also have the option to automatically save the motion to the character's perform list as well. Looks pretty good. You can naturally also import the original character mesh and apply the same motion in iClone. The results may vary depending on the character proportions, but they can be refined using iClone's motion tools. If we want to apply the motions to another character, you'll find that it will be saved in the External Motions folder of the Custom tab. Again, you can always move this to your own custom folder structure later using the Smart Content Manager. That's it for this quick video on how to import your external motions and apply them in iClone. Thanks for watching, guys, and I'll see you in the next video.